So recently, I had a student ask me a very interesting question. So we conducted the FHIR Bootcamp where we had people interact with the Cerner and Epic sandboxes. So there is an interesting thing that happens, especially with the Cerner sandbox. So if you take a look at the Cerner sandbox here, so you can launch applications from this, obviously, and we actually build applications in the FHIR Bootcamp alongside all the students. So here, this particular application, so I'll try to see if I can open up the network tab real quick here. Okay, so this one loaded first. That's fine. So I'm going to the network and it is getting a bunch of observations. So I'm going to just close this. So we got multiple observations, and you see that this is just observations from the EHR. So these are just vital signs, and we are getting it from the Cerner EHR. Now, what was interesting, again, it's not a perfect app. They didn't probably like make this display look nice. So SpO2 on 0 to 15, I think there is a value for it. It's just not handled in the app correctly. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's have a look at that. Let's make this a little bigger for you. So if we have a look at the value quantity here, so it's 98%. Okay, it's just not being displayed accurately. But here, this 98% is the percentage for SpO2. But the question that the student asked me was, why is SpO2 location, which is like where the SpO2 was measured, why is this a different resource? So you see here that the observation resource has this 98%, but the next resource that comes after it actually has exactly the same date time. But if you take a look at it, it is actually, it has this value codable concept with a code of SpO2 location. And the value codable concept then has right hand, right? So it doesn't really make sense, right? Because if you are measuring an SpO2 observation, you want this data to go together with the SpO2 location. So I just wanted to talk about this and discuss this in a little bit in depth at least. So if we take a look at the US Core implementation, right? So what they do is they tell you how certain things are supposed to be represented. So you have, for example, the US Core pulse oximetry profile. And I want to understand from the EHR vendor's perspective, like why they might have done this. And this might give us a few answers with regards to what we can learn from FHIR as a data standard, where it lacks, and why this actually happened. Okay. So now, if we take a look at the US Core for pulse oximetry, they properly mention, like where you're supposed to measure all this. And again, this is a full pulse oximetry code. So this is the pulse oximetry code, and they are asking you to use this particular code. What they miss out is what Cerner wanted to represent here. So they did not represent SpO2 location at all. And Cerner kind of wanted to represent this somehow as a FHIR resource. So they saw the US Core profile and there is nothing here that they can use. However, if you take a look at the vitals profile, so for example, there is a blood pressure panel here. And in the blood pressure panel, you have this extension for, let's say body position, sleep status, exercise association, measurement setting. And you have all of these extensions that are used for blood pressure. But if you come to the pulse oximetry, you don't have something which Cerner actually wanted to represent, which was the location, right? So they had two options here. So one was they could have added an extension. And again, like I'm going to show you how an extension looks like here in a second. So if we take a look at this JSON, so this is a blood pressure panel example. And this is using the blood pressure panel profile. Now, under extension, they have this sitting position right here, right? And you have all of these different attributes. And the meaning of what this actually is just represented by this URL, right? So if you don't know what this URL means, you're completely lost. You have no idea what this particularly means, right? Now, if we take a look at what Cerner has done here, they are actually representing the pulse oximetry location using this code, which actually, you know, one is their own internal FHIR Cerner code, but the other one is, interestingly, it's a LOINC code, right? Like, so it is already standardized. So there is a LOINC representation for this particular entity, which is pulse oximetry site. And technically, I'm pretty sure there is a LOINC representation for blood pressure location or blood pressure sleep status as well. But since US Core profile like redefines it again in the extension, the only way to like represent this meaning is by using this particular URL, right? So, and it just like, I can't help but look at the other side and just see how they have done it, which is how openEHR has decided to represent something like pulse oximetry. So in fact, let's just check pulse oximetry in the CKM. So if you take a look at it, you have the SpO2, and you even have like representations of which LOINC code it is and which SNOMED code actually represents this SpO2. But along with that, you actually have exertion, inspired oxygen, pulse oximetry device, sensor site. So this pulse oximetry site here, and it represents that particular LOINC code, which is the pulse oximetry site, 200816. So if you take a look at exactly what Cerner has done, they've actually done exactly the same thing, 200816, right? So openEHR, this clinical model has actually defined almost everything that pulse oximetry needs, and someone like Cerner could like literally represent their internal data using something like openEHR, and when bringing it out to another FHIR profile, they're actually limited only by how the FHIR core, US core profile defines this particular entity. So in this case, there is really no particular entity that lets them capture the SpO2 location. So they could have done an extension, but then if they did an extension, they will literally lose out on that LOINC code. So instead, they decided to go with another entirely new observation resource, which to me is like mind baffling, like, because these things belong together, but they decided to split it. And we can see this even more. So if you take a look at this, blood pressure method and blood pressure location is represented separately, because although the blood pressure vitals panel has things about body position, sleep status, and exercise association, they do not have anything about the method or location. So Cerner is like forced to use another observation resource, because that's the only way possible. If you want to use a LOINC code, like that's the only option. I just wanted to talk about this because, you know, if you take a look at blood pressure under CKM, under openEHR, if you take a look at all of these findings, so you have all of these. So you have sleep status, you have position, sitting, standing, you have confounding factors, you have like exactly what you need here. You have cuff size, and you have the method, like was it auscultation, palpation, machine. So it's almost like when people talk about healthcare interoperability, especially when they talk about FHIR, I feel that talking about this without talking about the data models and what is being used underneath to represent the data models does not make any sense, right? Like, so the same thing, for example, here, openEHR, which is like pretty mature, and this is the, you know, like if we take a look at what version of resource this is, So this is the blood pressure V2. Like it's been iterated on. It's been, latest published. It's a 2.0.8 version. They're iterating on this. People are working on this. And in fact, if you take a look at the attribution, like more than, I don't know, maybe 100 people have helped in coming up with this global data model, right? And all of these data points are just like pure gold. And for a US or for a FHIR profile in general, I'm not like talking specifically about the US core profile, for anyone doing FHIR profiling to just reject all of this data modeling effort only to come up with something that happens to be a subset of what was already established, to me is like mind baffling, right? And I don't know what you think about this. And if you do have any comments, do let them know in the comments below. And I think more people need to know that data models are the key. If two people can't agree on how to represent an entity, then it's always going to be messy. It's always going to be lossy mapping and lossy translations. So I hope this video was helpful. That's it for this one. I'll see you again in the next one. So I see that you're still sticking around after the end of the video. So if you want hands-on training on FHIR and want to know what this is all about from the very basics till actually interacting with real-world EHRs like Epic or Cerner, we have a bootcamp that is tailored specifically for you. And you can find the link in the description down below. So if you or someone that you know will benefit from this, do let them know. And I'm really happy to, see people come and actually learn and better their careers as well as ask these interesting questions. So hoping to see you in one of my bootcamps. Bye-bye.